Hello everybody and welcome back to Grass Simulator 17. I mean, Farm Simulator 17 with me, the Great Gamer. Yeah, we've got quite a bit of production going on over there with the power food. I fed the cows some more power food. I'll show you there. You can see how much power food they've got. We're running out of grass. So I went ahead and got the workers going here. Last time I didn't windrow this. So leaves a lot more rows, if you will. But what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to windrow it. And I'm not going to speed up time so that it doesn't grow. So it's easier to see. It's not going to change how many bales we get off of it, but it will make it easier for collecting. And what I'm probably going to do is I'm going to do 3, maybe 4 rows of using the forage wagon, because it's easier to just get the cut grass and put it in the bunker at the mixing station over there. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Trying to see if they're gonna keep pace with each other or do I need to slow this guy down? Maybe. But yeah, that's gonna make it a lot nicer. Consolidate the rows. 1/3 less rows anyway. But same amount of hay coming off of them, so. Uh-oh, it's a race. Yeah, the mower's actually going a little bit faster. I'm going 11 miles an hour, and the mower's going 13 miles an hour. So that's not too shabby. Plus, we can clean up the little bits of grass that were cut from before and not picked up. All right, while these guys are working, let's go take care of our potato harvester. There we go. I finished up with that yesterday. So let's take this up to the back up to the farm. And like I said, we've got growth going at all different stages on our fields. So we'll have to sort that out later. But I don't want to speed up time this time until after I get the bales off of the off the field. Do I have space for this anywhere? Yeah, I'll put it in here. Is it gonna fit? Whoa. Close. But yeah, we'll put potatoes in here. And we did get that field planted down there for the straw, but the cows, that's what I meant to say, the cows are in need of straw. So let me go take a quick look here. Yeah, they need a little bit of straw and so do the pigs. So let me take this up to the pigs first and then I'll come back and take some down to the cows as well. I pushed that bale, that one straw bale, I pushed it farther in, so it might take as soon as it gets low enough, I don't know. But we'll take this loose straw up here, and what the pigs don't use, we'll give to the give to the cows. That's my thinking anyway. I don't think they'll take all of this. Then again, they might, and if they do, so be it. That's okay, because they are the cash crop. They are the cash crop on the farm. Wow. Buildings, fences, come on, Gray. Wow, okay, they didn't take much at all. So I'm gonna head on down to the cow farm with this, and we'll meet you down there. So we made it down here to the cows, and I was thinking on the way down here that this is gonna be pretty good, because I can get in here, unload this. And as you can see, they're maxed out, but they didn't take very much. But what I can do is I can put down the catch, turn it on, and I can drive through here and fill it back up. See what I'm doing here, guys? Not the best maneuver, but it works, so I'm using it. And like I said, it goes a lot slower than you'd think, but look at what we're doing. We're getting this loose straw cleared out of here. Okay, so we're now at 100% full, and the sheep are full, the cows are full. So what I'm gonna do with this is I'm gonna put this in the bunker for the mixer. As you can see, we're keeping it going pretty good. I can back this up without too much trouble. There we go. Unload. Very good. As you can see, we're doing our best to keep it going. So what I'm going to do is, I know I've got that other forage wagon right there, but because I've got this one right at hand, I'm going to use it, and we're going to see how much of this it takes to fill this up. And I'm going to take some of this down to the, I got bales down there. I was going to say I'm going to take some of this to the sheep, but I don't need to take it to the sheep because the sheep are good. So we'll definitely use this to, fill up the bunker with grass. I'm trying to keep an eye on those guys to see if they are getting done with each other. I want to move the mower before the tetherer gets over there. So this is almost full. Okay, I'm full. Let me head on over. Then I'll jump after I empty this, I'll jump over and move the mower so there's no conflict between the mower and the windrower. Get in here, unload. There we go. All right, get the mower out of the way. Don't let me stop you. All right, well, I've got one more thing I want to do this episode. So let me go take care of that before I let you guys go. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop off my mower here, hopefully without flipping it. Oh, man, come on. Seriously? Turn around here. There we go. Line that up. Lower that down. Disconnect. And then park this right here. There we go. All right, let me get over here on my map. And I need to change this over. Okay. Now, field 8. We're going to go visit. Here's field 8. And if you guys don't remember, Abel Nelson. I'm going to do this harvest for him. I want to max out my rep with Abel. I want to max out my rep with everybody. But I want to definitely max out my rep with Abel so that I'm going to buy him out. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let me think this through here, guys. Let me think this through. I could buy this field right now for $64,832. And I could get the harvest off of it. And we got the potatoes. We don't need it. Let's go ahead and take the mission. And the Lamborghini. I'm liking it. All right, it gives me 37 minutes to do this, so that's pretty good. Takes me that long just to hook up to the equipment, but hey, who's counting, right? All right, let's unfold the harvester. Did I unfold it? Turn it on. Tab to the front, lower that down, turn it on. All right, get in position here. And I want to make sure the harvester is picking up the beets. There we go. Looks like it is. All right, I'll set my cruise control. And I will catch up with you guys after I finish this. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to stay on this field for the next couple of days. Do everything he needs me to do, you know, in terms of fertilizing or what have you. And then, in other words, just totally rep out with him. And then buy it right before he gets to another stage like this. In other words, right before he gets ready to harvest something off of it, buy it off of him, so that we reap the benefits of the purchase and the crop. Yeah. All right, I'll be back after we finish this. All right, I'm back and I'm about ready to put this in the ground. Well, actually I'm taking it out of the ground, but you guys know what I mean. Some of you might be saying, Gray, why are you picking on Abel? Well, back when I was a rookie farmer in FarmSim 17, I failed a mission because I didn't know what I was doing. And I failed it on this farm. So, yeah. Abel gave me a bunch of grief because I messed up his harvest the first time around. And, you know, I said to myself, okay, well, the day's going to come, buddy, when I'm going to buy you out and you're going to work for me. Yep. That's what happened. That's my story. Or that's my recollection of it anyway. I hope this finishes it off, otherwise I have to go clean up scraps. So yeah, the picking on Abel will continue. Are you going to give it to me yet? Abel's listening, isn't he? He's standing right behind me, isn't he? All right. 15,176 and a bonus of 3,598. And there we go. We're about halfway with Abel Nelson. So, yeah, we're going to fertilize. We're going to do everything we need to do. But we'll do that next episode. Thank you guys for stopping by and checking me out. I do appreciate it. And we will see you tomorrow.